everybody. It's Dr. Joe and Brian. He's going to be my awesome assistant today. And I'm going to show you how to do the apprehension test for the shoulder. So let's get started. Disclaimer alert. So I'm going to go ahead and have Brian lie down and get comfortable. He's kind of on the edge of the bed, but you want your patient to be super comfortable, super relaxed. They can put their legs straight out or bent up like his. It's completely up to whoever you're testing it on. So the apprehension test for the shoulder is really to check for a shoulder dislocation. It's also called the crank test because you're kind of cranking on the shoulder. But just to let you know, with special tests, just because it's positive, which the positive means if there's pain, it doesn't necessarily mean he's had a shoulder dislocation. It might mean his shoulder's not stable. It might mean it's weak and the muscles are making it nice and loose and things like that. So just because it's a positive test doesn't mean that is specifically what it is. If there's pain with the test, then that means there's something going on with the shoulder and you probably need to do some further tests or go see your doctor or physical therapist. So what you want to do is you're going to take the arm and put it into about 90 degrees of abduction. So that's coming out to here. And then the elbow is going to be at a 90 degree as well. So, oh, hey up there, how you doing? So 90 here, 90 here. And what you want to do is then go into external rotation of the shoulder, which is going back into that stop sign kind of movement. Now, if I take it and he's relaxed, I'm doing the movement for him. If I go back this way and I'm looking at him and he kind of gets his eyes really big, or if he actually says that hurts, that's a positive apprehension sign. He's got that apprehension going on. So another way to test to see is it really just hurting or is that shoulder unstable? You can take your other hand and push down going this way to keep that shoulder in place. And if it feels better when I do that, then that is the sign that that shoulder is not stable. It's not really staying in that joint very well, or maybe he has had a dislocation and we need to really strengthen that area. So that was your apprehension test for the shoulder to test for dislocation. It's also called the crank test, but just remember with these special tests, there's lots of false positives and there's lots of false negatives. So just one test being positive or negative doesn't mean you have that condition. But I always say, if you can reproduce pain doing it, because if you do it on the other side, it shouldn't bother that shoulder at all if there's no injury. If it hurts, then you need to go into a little more investigating to find out what's going on. So remember, shoulder abduction to 90 and then external rotation. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. If you'd like to get some stretches and exercises to help if you have that positive test, make sure and click up here. And if you'd like to help support my channel, find out how clicking here. And don't forget to subscribe by clicking down here. And remember, be safe, don't be apprehensive, have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.